Hi, my name is Don Butler. I'm the Executive Director of Connected Vehicle and Services for Ford, and we're here at Mobile World Congress. Mobile World Congress, that word mobile used to mean mobile device, and now we're talking about mobility and being able to connect across different pathways of your journey. And we say connect and connectivity for Ford, we think about that in three different facets. First, there's what we call beamed-in connectivity, or the vehicle as a receiver. So satellite radio and radio, for instance, would be that kind of connectivity. And then we talk about broad-in connectivity, so leveraging the capability of a smartphone, for instance, that you would bring into the vehicle and being able to interact with that smartphone, have access to the contacts, the content, the media, and do it by voice with our sync system. And then finally, when we say connectivity, we mean built-in connectivity. The vehicle as its own independent node on the network with an embedded modem and having the ability to both transmit as well as receive data. One of the best examples of built-in connectivity actually is the Ford Focus electric vehicle that you see here behind me. The Ford Focus electric vehicle has an embedded modem built into the vehicle. And in a moment, we'll show you with a remote app that you'd be able to actually see the state of the battery charge, for instance, and precondition the vehicle, all while outside the vehicle. Actually, you can be many, many miles away from the vehicle. So that connectivity enables you to seamlessly interact and seamlessly make things happen that wouldn't require you to actually be physically present with the vehicle. Finally, when we talk about connectivity, it's important that we take care of security. And so everything from the basics of having encryption on the data that goes to and from the vehicle, making sure that we are checking the command structure to make sure that we haven't had a foreign command or something that we can't interpret come in, as well as having our back-end systems monitor what's going on so we can make sure not only that the commands are successful, but they're executed in the right way. Security is very, very important to us. And then a final facet is data. The data that's generated by this vehicle is your data. It's the customer's data. And at Ford, we are the stewards of the data. What that means is we take care that it's secure and that it's safe, but we also leverage that data to add value. Adding value, for instance, by allowing you to precondition that vehicle based on the state of battery charge, for instance. So you'll get a chance to see some of that as we demonstrate it in just a moment.
Is the MyFord Mobile app. It's showing you the vehicle that's behind me right now. Vehicle we have named Mobile Marion, and the status is that it's unplugged. The vehicle has 79% charge in its battery, allowing you to go 69 kilometers on that charge. So one of the things that we can do with this app is we can find charge stations around us. So I've just clicked on the plug button here, and what it's going to do is it's going to pull up a map. The car there shows you the location of the car right now. And around it, as you can see, are a variety of different charge stations. If you select one, it'll give you some information about it. And whatever information's available, we can present. So it's just over a kilometer away. It has, well, this is a bad one. It has no charge stations available. Let me pick a different one.
But that's good information to know. There's no charge stations available.
Exactly. So this is a little further away, but it has a 240-volt charge station available. It's a public access, and it's available 24/7. So these are kinds of things that are available to us that we can show to the customer so they can have an easier time of figuring out where they can go to get their vehicle charged. One thing we can do from the outside of the vehicle as you approach the vehicle is we can lock or unlock the vehicle. There are things that we cannot do. We cannot remotely start the vehicle. That's not allowed here in Europe. But we can lock or unlock the vehicle. There's a variety of other things that we can do with the app. So you can see a couple of things, and I will show you some screenshots that I've taken because it's a little difficult to do that with just one finger. But we can plan a trip, we can locate a vehicle. How many times have you ever parked your vehicle and have lost it because you can't remember where it is? This will help you find it. You can also check in on your vehicle from anywhere in the world. If your vehicle is in Germany and you're here in Barcelona, you can check on your vehicle, the status of the battery, where it is, what it's doing, you can check on it. You can also do something called charge settings. If I can just go into that just for a minute. you can set the interior cabin temperature. So, for example, right here on Tuesday at 8 o'clock, I want the cabin temperature to be at 18.5 degrees Celsius. So just before 8 o'clock, the battery will turn on and either heat or cool the vehicle to the desired temperature so that when I get into the vehicle, it's not either cold or too hot. It's at the right temperature for me to drive to work. And I can do that for after work or whenever I'm interested. The other thing that this screen shows down at the bottom is if I'm driving to a grocery store, I might not have time to wait around. I want to charge the vehicle now. I can activate this to charge right now. But perhaps you're at home and you have time. And some states, some cities have cheaper rates for midnight to 3 a.m., let's say, for example. You can set that charge, it's called value charge, to charge the vehicle when it's cheapest for you as a customer, so that you're not incurring a lot of cost to charge your electric vehicle, but you're doing it when it's the cheapest.
Another aspect that's underneath our total smart mobility strategy is autonomous driving. And even today, within Ford vehicles, we have the precursors that will allow us to progress along the autonomous path. Precursors like lane keep assist, assisted parking, collision warning and detection, adaptive cruise control that slows the vehicle down automatically and speeds the vehicle up automatically. We envision a progression of these technologies to the point that vehicles will become more and more capable of autonomous. In order for full autonomous capability to come into being, technically we can see within 5 years that we'll have the technical ability to do that. But you still need regulatory and societal areas to also blend so that we can deliver true autonomy. Consumers will have to become comfortable with not driving but being driven. And from a regulatory standpoint, we're going to need laws modified and changed to adapt for autonomous vehicles. But we're excited about what that future means because we know it'll be a safer, more efficient future as well, enabled and underneath the umbrella of Ford Smart Mobility.